I know I missed another upload day, and I'm sorry, but in all seriousness, my laptop is crappy, and the video I was working on for the 20th got lost when my laptop decided to crash. You know, like it did on my live stream. But anyways, we're back with a whole new video, and to be honest, I don't feel as if I was being fair to Ayano in my Ryoba video. I made her out to be this failed character deviation of a Yandere. I, at least, gave Ayano the benefit of the doubt and said that even if Ryoba is better, then that may be subject to change. When in all actuality, Ayano's character is a bit more complex than just
Songless Girl.
But you guys might ask, okay, if Ayano is so complex, then why say Ryoba is better? Well, she's what people asked for, so I can't help but feel as if her appeal is on a bit of a surface level. And because, well, the 1980s cast of characters are fully written. You guys might also ask, okay, if Ayano's character is so complex, then why do people feel as if she's bland? Again, that's mostly a surface level thing, to be honest. I've given character descriptions of her character in other videos of mine. I'ma just give a rundown here, since my character descriptions were hella dramatic back then. We all know that Ayano Aishi didn't really feel normal or complete for most of her life, and the only thing that she was looking forward to was meeting the one that would fix her, in a sense. I mean, before she met Taro, it has gotten so bad to the point where she has to put on a mask and make everyone think, "Hey, I'm normal," when deep down, she knows damn well she ain't normal. It's haunting her knowing how abnormal she is. She might have not felt much, yeah. She still had the desire to learn and understand why life is good. And when Taro pops up, she gets it. He brings light, warmth, and color to her world, and she finally understands the hype, and all the love songs start to make sense. Taro's the light at the end of her tunnel, and no, that's not an innuendo, and her desire for normalcy will take her to it. But with the rivals in the mix, there's also anger, but underneath that is fear. Fear that they'll take him away from her. Fear that she'll lose the one thing that completed her. Michaela Law said this in a live stream. I'm just summing it up in a video. But then again, she most likely knows that she can't go around stabbing whoever, so she hides that with the layer of blandness we all know damn well, as a means of being careful with her actions, because if she ain't careful, bye-bye, Taro. The only actual problem I see here is how bland she is on the outside, but that more or less seems to be the point. Just keep in mind that the base game is still in a demo phase, so everything in a demo won't be the end-all be-all. This story may have its flaws, like, why is meeting some guy the cure to this unknown illness? Is it a curse? Is it a genetic mishap? It's fun to theorize, but it proves that her story has its ways to go. There's going to be more down the line, and hell, it may be worth it in the end. Yandere Simulator characters just make me happy. Anyways, that's about it. Thanks forever. Love ya!